Hi, Max.
Hi, Vanessa.
Thanks for being with us today. Could you please introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Max Becker. I was born and raised in Switzerland. I was working in several international companies as an HR director. And I had been the president of HR Zurich. And the reason why I'm here today is that I am the treasurer of the European Association for People Management, representing HR Switzerland.
Yeah. So could you briefly present HR Zurich?
Well, we have to differentiate. We have the local communities like Zurich with about 2,500 members. And then we have HR Switzerland, which is the, say, umbrella association all mm-hmm. over Switzerland with about 6,000 members. And peculiarity is certainly that we are living in a country with four different languages. So we have a German part, as you know, a French part, Italian part, and Retro-Romance. And that makes sometimes communication quite challenging.
Yeah. And if you can, if you could describe the spirit of the association in three words, what would they be?
International.
Mm-hmm.
Action-oriented. Collaborative.
Okay, and talking about action, what were the activities carried out this year about your association?
Well, we are following different tracks. First of all, as a visible product, we have a national congress mm-hmm. once every 2 years in Bern, which is the capital of Switzerland. And then we have different streams in terms of communication. We have our own magazine. We have obviously communities dealing with certain technical or professional questions like compensation and benefits, and then we are active online, obviously. HR Swiss is supporting the regional organization when they try to increase the number of members, because as an individual in Switzerland, you cannot be a member of HR Switzerland, you're always a member of the local community. Basel, Bern, Geneva, to mention the most important ones. So it's a two-step approach, so to say.
And do you have all kind of enterprises represented in your association?
Absolutely, yes. We have a lot of, first of all, international companies. You know, Switzerland is a hub for international companies. Then we also have many public service institutions, of course. And if you look at Geneva, for example, with the ILO, with the Red Cross, and with the World Economic Forum, they're all also part of HR Swiss.
Okay. And did you play a big role in the discussion on the HR standard with ISO?
Frankly speaking, this is not... or it has not been the top priority to us.
Okay.
ISO is
because
not
ISO
so
is in Geneva, so why not?
We're talking about ISO or ILO?
ISO also have a...
Okay, they may have an office there, yes.
Yeah.
But I would say where we were much more active in the past is the question of HR certification. I think this is a success story in our country. We have a certification system. It's probably something like what CIPD has done over the past years, and we have something like 4,000 people per year which are certified on different levels, on managerial level, on professional level, and on beginner's level. But this is a success story, and HR Swiss was the leading institution to have this introduced, together with employers associations, together with trade unions, and together with the representative of the government to make it official.
Okay. And so would you say that the field of HR play a very strong role in Switzerland?
I think so, yes. Yeah. We would say that the quota of HR people in any given corporation should be around about 1%.
Okay.
So if 1% of the workforce is in HR,
it's already
that's a strong representative. Yeah.
True. And what would be the main issues that your members are confronted with in their work?
Well, basically, you cannot abstain from the political situation in Switzerland. Certainly, migration is a big topic for us.
Mm-hmm.
Impatriates and expatriates both. And then, of course, training. We have, I think, by all international standards, a lot of people that go through apprenticeships.
Okay.
Followed by, of course, university education. So HR Switzerland is very active on all these educational levels, apprentices, universities of applied sciences, up to the federal Swiss Federal Technical University.
Yep. But after the apprenticeship, do this the students can find a job easily in Switzerland?
Well, our overall unemployment rate is 3% overall.
Yeah. Okay.
And if you look at the people right after apprenticeship, it's certainly considerably less than 3%.
Okay.
So if you have gone through that program, which is normally a 3 or 4 year program, you have absolutely good chances to get integrated very quickly.
Okay.
We do have more problems on the side of the elderly people. So 55 plus is more of a problem, of course, with digitalization like in other countries.
Sure.
If you lose your job and you are 59, it becomes difficult also in our country.
Okay. And if we come back if we come back to the Congress, one of the subject matter being discussed here today is job quality and working life in Europe. So what is good work for you, and what would be the lever action to improve job quality?
You ask difficult questions, eh?
Yeah.
Well,
the last one.
I don't want to start with work-life balance, but I think recognition from most of our people on the workplace, recognition is today very important. Now the question is, how can recognition be made visible?
Mm-hmm.
It can be made visible with money,
yeah.
But there mostly
easy.
The limitations are there. So the selection of bosses who are able and willing to recognize performances of their collaborators, to me is from my practice as HR director, one of the crucial points in HR life.
Okay.
Find the right bosses where you can rely on,
and
who know their job, both in a professional and in a managerial sense.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you for your participation.
It was a pleasure, Vanessa.
Have a good time.
Thank you,
Paris.
Vanessa. Bye-bye. Thank